Hello learners, welcome to NIOS studio. I am Dr. Sunita Sundrial and today we will discuss about the topic types of management. This comes under the paper 507 Community and Elementary Education under DLED program run by NIOS for the online mode of education for distance learner. So before we begin the types of management, let us know about the aims of types of management studying. The aims are to know about the types of management, to understand the various process of participatory management in detail, to understand the principle, problems, skills required and limitations of participatory management, to know about non-participatory management process. Now we are well aware about the various types of management's aim. And keeping in mind these aims and objectives, let us proceed to our the main content, that is types of management. First of all, let us know what is management process. Management process deals with setting of goals, that is the targets, then planning, that how to reach and attain those goals, organizing to attain those goals, and executing the plans which have been made so that the goals can be attained. Basically, for the attainment of goals, all these processes are done. Through the steps of management, we can know how we can carry out our work successfully. Now, let us understand who carries out the management process. There must be someone who starts and carries forward this process, and usually the leader of the project carries out the management, but only with the help of his or her subordinates and the various resources. The leader may instruct or distribute responsibilities to his subordinate leaders in their own ways so that the management process can be carried out efficiently. Now let us understand the various aspects of management. As a process, management consists of three aspects. First is that it is a social process. Second, it is an integrating process. And third, it is a continuous process. Management process is a social process as we belong to a society and the working should be in favor of people and community. It should be concerned with developing relationship among members of the society. Management is integrating process which includes and integrates all the people and systems involved in the process. Therefore, harmony should be brought about among these factors. Lastly, management is a process which goes on continuously and it does not mean that it has ended if a project has ended. It means there are more scope for modification and improvements in the next project which is to be undertaken. So, keeping these aspects in mind, the management process deals with many things. Management process deals with people basically. And on the basis of people participation, it is of two types. Participatory management process, where the people participate in the whole management process, and non-participatory management process. Let us look at the figure projected in front of you. What do you see in the figure? In the picture, a lot of people are working with some task or other. Two members are around the paper, and there is another female pinning some papers to the board. All of these people are actively engaged. If we look carefully, we will be able to see how there is one man looking over a big spreadsheet and nearly all members face him or are handing something to him. What does this picture project to you? It projects that all are working equally in their own manner. Some is studying, some is portraying, some is explaining, and some is listening. So, in this way, all are equally involved in the whole management process. What is the process of participatory management? In participatory management, the participants are encouraged, but the final decision is taken by the group leader only. Participatory management is the practice of empowering members of a group to participate in decision making. Participatory management came into existence because the participants were losing interest in putting their efforts or opinion as they were neither motivated or given recognition. So came into being the participatory management. In participatory management, the participants are encouraged to participate, but the final decision is taken by the group leader only. Taking decision is the final call of the leader, though it may be influenced by the views and the suggestions of the participant. The leader shows democratic style of leadership in which ideas move freely. The ideas are exchanged, discussion is open and healthy. Information collected is synthesized to draw best possible decision and features. So, the leader shows democratic style of leadership in participatory type of management process. Let us understand what are the aims of participatory management process. The aim behind or the theory behind participatory management is to understand the culture of the organization, what is the environment of the organization, understand the norms, values and ideals for which the institute or organization stands for, that means what it is kept as norms or what it has kept as vision, what values does it carry, and knowing the working of organization. The aim should be to know how the organization works, how it functions, to use power distributed amongst the participants. The people working under a leader should be given power, should be allotted certain responsibilities, to play accordingly and undertaking responsibility, to make decisions so that they are apt in making decisions, adopt self-facilitated and self-sustained approach. That means they have to be apt and facilitating themselves so that they can take decision and take responsibility further. Provide participants with tools to assess the existing or future problems which may occur. Functions based on contingency leadership model, that is helping each other. Empower and enhance the employees' understanding of problems and generate potent solution. It is necessary that employees work together to face any problems arising in any situation and together coordinating work for a proper solution. Now we can see that the aim of participatory management process is to make the participants more confident and engaging. Moving on to another slide projected before you, look at the picture. Colorful people arranged in a proper manner. We see a man in the front with two people connected to him. The two people behind him are connected to few more, and thus the chain goes on and they are all interlinked. Clearly, the one in the front is the leader, while the people behind him are connected and are subordinates. Similarly, all the members are connected in the form of a web. Let us see the significance of such network. Here are some principles for participatory management. So, try to understand the principles behind this type of management. Here, ready to share the responsibilities of leader should be there in the participants. Awareness of the aims of the organization. Not only the leader but also the subordinates should know what is the aim of the organization. Belief and trust on people working in the group, otherwise they cannot coordinate well. Follow all the rules of management. Read to critically assess one's working. Now look at the picture, the projected before you. The people are talking, sharing something. What do you think they are doing? They are looking at each other, discussing something and trying to understand. Someone is scratching his chin to think what the other person is saying. Someone is listening attentively. Many figures are exchanging information and talking to each other. The figure expresses that some accept it, some doubt it, and some don't understand the credibility of it. So, let us understand on the basis of picture how important information exchange is to a management process. Exchanging in ideas, exchanging information, exchanging any feedback is very, very important when there is participatory type of management process. The process involving participatory management are information sharing, training, offering development opportunities, decision making, rewards for motivation. As the following slide tells you that in the process, the information sharing is utmost important and the people working should be trained properly. They must have required qualification and essential experience. They should be given proper opportunities and chances so that they can showcase their skills. They should be able to make decision whenever given chances, and if decision is taken right and they are successful in doing work, they should be rewarded by giving them motivation or reinforcement. Now let us understand what are the requirements for participative management. Certain things are required in leader as well as subordinates, the members, so that the participative management process can undergo a smooth process. Leader must be willing to relinquish some control to their subordinates. Leader must feel secure for successful participation. Leader must realize that his respect will increase. He should never fear that if he works with the members, his respect will go down. He should always have a secure front in front of the members. Leader must therefore realize that he is to be respected, he has to involve equally, and it should be planned properly. Therefore, the control is handed to the leader so that no longer wholly in power, but the subordinates also enjoy equal power. The approach should be a slow one and things should be done stepwise. The proceedings should be gradual. That means it should be changed gradually from autocratic to democratic style to participative style of management. Learners, you must have seen video, or you can refer my video where we have talked about various styles of leadership. And autocratic leadership style is a little bit rigid type of style, whereas in democratic style all play equal part. That means the participative leadership style is gradual movement from autocratic style to the democratic style and then to the participative style of management process. Leader must be genuine, honest and dedicated. Trust bond is very, very necessary. Each member should trust another one. Leader must approach with open mind. He should be ready to communicate everything and listen to people properly. The leader should also know the strength and weaknesses of participant so that the task can be assigned in the best manner possible. By playing to the strengths of the member, the leader will ensure that they perform to the best of their abilities and remain in their comfort zone. Constant encouragement and motivation is also necessary. Participating members must be enlightened with all the criteria. Subordinates must be made to know that they have made a contribution. The confidence of participants must be built so that whatever they are doing, they are motivated. If the confidence and morale of the participant is boosted properly, they can work together for the progress. So, subordinates must be made to know that they are contributing in a positive manner, and leader must let them know time to time so that they work together for the betterment. Now look at the slide picture shown before. You look at the picture, what do you see? Can you see the people in the picture doing something? What do you think they are doing? Why do you think they do so? Are they all performing in a similar manner? The picture shows men and women trying to place the wheels at their respective slots. Some are pushing the wheel, some placing the wheel, and some are trying to set the wheel into the right direction. They are all in different position, indicating that their work is of different, if not of varying levels or nature. You must have played jigsaw puzzle. It is almost similar to the jigsaw puzzle, where the wheels are of different sizes and shapes in the outer surface, where they are corrugated in a different design and they are to be fixed properly. Let us understand what are the skills required for participatory management process. The skills required are readiness and willingness. If the member isn't ready to perform, he doesn't have his heart into it, he won't be able to deliver. Thus, the leader also should make sure that the member gets the task he is most comfortable with. Second is utilizing one's strength and overcoming weakness. Again, this applies to the member as well as the leader. The members can work on themselves and use their strengths properly. So members must know how they can use and utilize their strengths and overcome weaknesses. And next is good communication skill, a very important skill, because without interaction, without talking with each other, without any discussion, we cannot pass on our ideas, our suggestions, and what we feel is required for the job of participatory management process. So all these three we have discussed, that is readiness and utilizing strength, overcoming weakness, and good communication skills are the skills required for participation. Besides this, ready to coordinate and compromise, the person should be always ready to compromise, adjust according to the situation. There should be flexibility in the working, work with concern and responsibility. There should be problem solving tactics. That means member should always be ready to compromise, and if the problem arises, should be able to be flexible enough to solve the problem and adjust accordingly. They should also be eager to take on whatever task they are given, as they realize it takes time to establish one's credibility. It is a given that they work with concern and responsibility. So moving on to the effects of participatory management process. When the participation of the subordinate takes place in any management process, effects can be seen. What are these effects? Let us take them one by one. You will see that there is increased efficiency and productivity. It motivates the participants. Members get job satisfaction and quality of work is enhanced. That means the people, when they participate, they are given equal weightage, they are given importance. As a result, their efficiency and productivity increases. They are motivated to participate more and more, and in doing so, they become satisfied in whatever they are doing, and their quality of work also increases. Besides this, it promotes sustainable management practices, social acceptability increases, leads to empowerment of subordinate, and creativity level increases. The heavy participation keeps the communication open, and hence the work atmosphere becomes socially open and acceptable. Due to this, the people are motivated and they want to do something new, something better. As a result, the creativity level increases. Obviously, since the process are involved, the problems may be arising in the processes, so we should know what are those processes, and we will highlight them one by one. The first problem which may arise during participatory management process is the trust issue, because as we know, people are participating, they are interacting with each other, so obviously with discussion comes various trust issue, whether they believe in each other or not, whether they want to believe in each other or not, or whether they agree with what the other person has to share. So there may be disturbed relationship between the members, and then also trust issues arise when two people are not in cordial relationship in a team. So the collective understanding lead to conflict. When there is discussion, there may be conflict also. And due to conflict, disturbed relationship and trust issues, the uncertainty may arise. Lack of clarity during communication, because people are not in a good term or good relationship, the communication may be hindered. Slow decision making, as there may be conflict, people may not agree upon one point. Culture and ego clash may happen. Confidentiality is lost as employees have access to valuable information. Too much risk involved. The more freedom to speak means there will be more suggestions, ideas, and thoughts. This may result in chaos if not regulated by the leader. So, as we saw, that interrelationship may not be good. There may come ego in between, and clash may happen, conflict may happen, there may be cultural differences also. So the decision making, the planning, the proceeding of the work may hamper. And besides this, when everybody is participating in a process, the confidentiality of that work, of that project is lost, all people know everything about that project. And I think to know everything about the project by all is not good for that particular project, because some people may lead it for the failure of the project. So in that case, too much risk is involved. So these are the problems. Now let us see the another slide in which a picture is standing in between and he is limited by certain barricading. And it seems that he is enclosed in a circle. What do you guess from this picture? The figure holds its hands up in helplessness. It is limited to a sphere. It is a symbolic of real life barriers imposed upon a person. Let us look upon the limits within the participatory management process. So, with a process of projects come limitations, and these limitations are: not all can be invited for participation as certain skills are required as job. Not all have zeal to take responsibility. All do not feel at ease at some or good followers. Conflict may arise. As you can see the limitations, you must have understood that all people cannot participate. You know that when a program is going on, some take part in a program, but some are audience. So all do not possess the skill to participate in any project. And also there are some members who want to take a back seat. They do not want to come out in open to participate in that project. And some, it has been seen in any management process, are good followers. They do not want to participate and come out as leaders. So in that case, the conflict may arise in the situation. Besides this, other limitations are: some may come under pressure and stress. The people may feel pressured, the people may feel stressed because a sword is hanging on their head that the work is to be done as they are participating. It may demotivate some who are unable to participate. Employees can be manipulated. Lethargic people do not agree with this type of management process. What does this mean? This means that the employees who are participating may not be playing their part according to their will. The leader may be manipulating him or her according to his instructions. And sometimes in that process, the participants may be demotivated and also the pressure level may go up high. Besides this, there are many lazy people in a team who do not agree with this type of management process. They feel that all cannot participate in a project because too many cooks spoil the broth. When many people are engaged in a project, it may lead to the failure because all come up with their own ideas, all come up with their own style of working. So it may not result in a successful project. So learners, you must have understood what the participatory management process is. Now look at this slide projected before you. What do you see in that slide? Very special slide in which the people are looking up at a person who is saying something and the people are listening carefully with a smile. What are the other members doing? When we study the picture, we observe the man on a higher step above the others. He is blowing a horn from his mouth through which he is blaring at people. The blow horn signifies that he is the sole authority and is giving directions. The people or his subordinates do not mind though. They seem pleased at whatever the leader is telling them. In this picture, it is very clear the person standing in front is the leader and the people who are standing are just the followers. They are happy and ready to follow him, whatever he is saying. They do not want to come out in open and take any sort of responsibility. They want to do whatever is being instructed to them. And they do not want that they should be blamed for any failure or any wrong during the project working. So this type of leadership is known as, this type of leadership or working is known as non-participatory management. As the word depicts, non-participatory means the person do not participate in the management process. They work as passive people. The interrelationship aspect is overlooked. The leader is only concerned with shelling out instructions to the subordinate and the relationship between them is strictly formal. As a result, members fail to feel at home in such atmosphere. They lack a sense of belonging. Their unhappiness or dissatisfaction is often ignored, more so because there is no means of expressing disapproval. It is almost opposite of participatory management. The leader takes almost all the decision. Subordinates work according to the instructions and responsibilities. Whatever the leader says, they are ready to follow. They do not want to play any sort of role. In this management process, the leader is an active member and the audience is, or the subordinates are, or the members are the passive members. They listen and do only that much which is allotted to them. They neither give suggestions, they are not interested in involving themselves in the process, and they just keep on following the instruction. The interrelationship aspect is overlooked, as I have already told you. And since the relationship aspect is overlooked, the employees lack sense of belongingness. Subordinates are kept away from many issues and decision making. It is almost like autocratic leadership, wherein the leader dictates and instructs. So they just follow the instruction and stick themselves or limit themselves to the project only to the level what they are told to do. So in that case, there is so much formality in the workspace, and as a result, the employees do not have any personal relationship either with the team members or with the leader, or they do not have any sense of belonging for the organization or for the job. They just do the job for the sake of doing the job. So in this way, today we have understood the different types of management process and how the participatory management process is always better than the non-participatory management process. And let me tell you, learners, that participatory management process is the new happening thing in the management world, in the world of organization, as the people, the leader want the participants to come up and support their team so that they can do better and better and reach the heights of success. So I hope you have understood this properly. Thank you for listening. Thank you.